Flashback to the class act. I didn't pass that long test. Don't press me. I'm a prestigious.
Welcome everyone to a new video. So it's been a few days since my Lecrae news video did really well with views and comments and stuff, and my internet went out pretty much like an hour afterwards, as in all my internet ran out. So I've had no internet for the last little bit. I guess it's been a good thing, a bit of a break, and I don't know what's happening. I don't know if any new music has come out. I know Lecrae's single has come out, but other than that, I don't know if Andy Mineo's released, or how Aha Gazelle's project's gone, or Caleb Mitchell's. But I just want to thank you guys so much for the support on that. I got a lot of subscribers from that video, and I guess it was good timing that it went out and then the internet ran out. So yeah, thank you guys for that. Welcome all you new guys to my channel. I also do opinion and topic kind of videos. I have taken down some of my previous ones, like problems with Christian hip hop, and quite a few of my old ones, because I guess I didn't like the way they came off. Even if I still believe some of what I said, I think my delivery wasn't that good. And I guess the last few months has definitely been, I mean, I've talked about this before, being a huge growing experience for me. There's been a whole lot of things that have happened at once which have really helped me grow, and I think I've talked about that in my 1,000 sub video, so I won't get into all that. But today we're going to be talking about John Gibbs leaving Christian hip hop. Now, I guess it hasn't really been a secret that John Gibbs has kind of been transitioning out of the whole Christian hip hop scene. When I made my Christian hip hop news video with John Gibbs in the thumbnail and in the title, I wasn't fully aware of all that was going on. I guess all I knew is that the Dream Junkies had ended, but making songs that certain people wouldn't like. I knew that he used particular words that people will be offended by, so swearing or the N-word or whatever. And I got a few comments about it, looked it up a bit more, and then kind of realized. So I probably won't be talking about John Gibbs in Christian hip hop news, or if I do, it'll probably just be an update on what he's up to, because I know people still care about him in the Christian hip hop space. And I listened to an interview that he did with DJ Wado. Really good interview, by the way. I'll hopefully link it up in the description. And it was pretty much John going over what's happening in his life, his direction. He's signed with Interscope Records now, and I think a lot of people, including myself, probably, I mean, 2 months ago, would have been pretty critical of him, saying that he's not a good influence on the younger kids. And in a sense, I guess that's true, but I guess that can happen for everyone. Obviously, different people grow up in different settings, different circumstances, are in different steps of their faith. So obviously for me, my life is a lot more different than John Gibbs. I believe he lives on the west coast of the US, so like California, I guess. He's probably had problems that I haven't faced here. I live in New Zealand, population of 4 million, and at the moment I live in the country, so it's a big difference. And obviously different people can be in different steps, whether they're still finding themselves in their faith, or if they've already done that, gotten through a lot of their issues, and then they talk about their testimony. And I think John Gibbs is still in that almost finding himself phase, and I don't think we should be too critical of that. I know he's being real authentic in this interview, and I know it can be kind of hard for other people to relate, whether he's been putting on a front this whole time and he hasn't been a true Christian, or I guess your beliefs on salvation could change that as well. But I just want to say I support John Gibbs, and maybe not in everything that he's doing, but just as a person to person, I hope the best for him. Whether he's a good influence for young Christian kids, I guess that's up to you to decide. I guess if you're a parent and you're worried about how he could influence your kids, I mean, I guess that's up to you. I guess once kids get to a certain age, they're gonna find a way to listen to music anyway. Probably a lot of Christian kids listen to secular rap and their parents have no idea about it, but I guess it's all up for your discernship. And I really encourage encourage you guys to go and listen to this interview. It was really, really good. It was really refreshing for me, a new perspective on things, and especially the story with him smoking outside of his show and there being an old drunk lady and him helping her out and then people at the show giving her weird looks. And I think there's a lot to learn from him and his journey, and yeah, I'd really encourage you guys to go and listen to that interview. Let me know your thoughts on what you think about John Gibbs. I know there's been a lot of comments on why he's not in Christian Hip Hop News, or why is he in Christian Hip Hop News, or have you heard about some of his latest songs having swearing in it? And I'm aware of it now, and you know, I guess we'll see. He's obviously growing, he's learning, and I guess I'm in that phase as well, and I guess I can relate to him in that way. And I think a lot of people, probably more my earlier subscribers, the more hardcore kind of Bible Christian Hip Hop people, I think need to have a bit more grace with him. I mean, obviously there can be the other side where it's too much grace and then you don't convict people with anything, but yeah, I don't know, those are just my thoughts. I just listened to the interview and just wanted to talk about it a bit, start up a conversation in the comments, and go and check out the interview. I know a lot of you guys like John Gibbs, he's been up and coming for a while, and obviously he's kind of going on a different path now, but I'll be interested in your guys' thoughts. I know a lot of you guys enjoyed the Dream Junkies as well. That is over, by the way. You'll never hear another Dream Junkies song again. That's for the people who aren't really in the know, but yeah, let me know your thoughts. Leave a like on this video if you enjoyed. Thank you everyone who's new for subscribing. I don't know how this video will come across. New videos should come out that are relevant to, I guess, the times. Once my internet gets back, which will be the day this goes up. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video.